all my friends say it goes by so fast. All of a sudden they're going to be out the door and I'm going to be like, okay, well then, hello, what do I do now? And I don't want that to happen either. But you're right. It's like you worry so much about what they're going to think and how they're experiencing it that like, if you're not living your best life for yourself, you're not showing up the same way as a parent too.
Right. You're not giving them the example of what is possible rather than having their example of mother be a mom that is there all the time, a mom that is, you know, that's a really beautiful gift to not only have them get to experience from the lived experience of it, and for them to also get to perceive, and now their program of mom is based off of what you've done as a mom, but you also want them, I'm assuming, this is what I think about, is I also want them to have this other definition of what a parent is. And it's a parent that has, you know, ups and downs, ins and outs, full social life, like a parent who has this existence in life completely separate from being a parent.
That lives a full life.
Yes. That lives that full, complete life.
Yes. We're one of my best friends is a behavioral like specialist. She's done this forever with like kids. And she and I have just started this conversation of my kids are so reliant on me. Like it's now becoming probably a bit of what they call like a codependency. So like, all right, now what? Because you can't tell somebody who's in like a codependent relationship, you can't tell them, oh, pull back entirely. So now you got to start with baby steps. And she gave me great advice. And it happened this weekend. My ex was taking the kids one day, the kids, I've got the pool in the back. I've got, you know, like this is their comfort zone. And they that morning were like, he's like, I don't know what they want to do. He offered to take them to a Red Sox game. One wanted to go, one didn't. The other one wanted to get her girlfriend to go for the day with them. And everything in me, past me, before having these deep conversations about shit, we got to go into the next chapter, would have been like, oh, I'll just keep them here and they could swim for a bit and then we'll figure it out. And I listened to my friend and I said, you're taking them, you figure it out. And you know how hard that is for me, who's like, well, and I had to explain to my kids, dad's got you, dad is making the plan. And this isn't to take anything away from him. It's just I enable everybody, including him. So now I'm like, everybody's capable. You've got this. And guess what came out of it? My son, he took the kids to his golf course to swim in the pool, to go out on the golf cart, to swing some balls. My son now is 7, cannot stop talking about golfing. He had to bring him again yesterday. This is a kid that doesn't want to leave me ever. He went again yesterday and now he's already talking about next. So again, it's like, it's look at the benefit that I just gave my kids. I didn't coddle everybody and say, just stay here where you're comfortable. It was like, no, you're going. And it turned out to be a great freaking day.
You so, said they're 9 and 7.
Yeah.
That's really a gift that you're given that early. Like did not figure that out when our kids were in that age range of 9 and 7. Like that's.
Well, I'm feeling it all and I'm giving myself the space to feel it. You know, it's like,
yeah.
And if I keep
it's hard.
Seeing things over and over, I've tried it all. A lot of this stuff is trial and error too. You know, I tried to spend every other weekend away from them when they were smaller and it was really great for me. It was really hard on them at that age. And I just was always torn. I was like, I can't tell you how many trips I made back in the middle of like having a fun weekend in Cape Cod to rush back home to be their savior. And I think it was important then, but now older ages, like I think they got to figure some of this out now.
So I love these conversations because there's so much of it that you don't know what you don't know. And when we have all these program beliefs, this is how you're supposed to show up. This is what mother looks like. This is what wife looks like. So father, this is what husband, all of these things that come up in space of this is what this looks like. It's not until somebody starts this conversation that, I mean, maybe you get inspired, maybe it comes through and you're like, I'm going to try it different. But for me, there were so many things that I didn't recognize. I didn't know until somebody shared it. Someone's like, I'm doing it this way. This is, you know, my kids are thriving in this. And it's almost like this, oh, I get to break this mold. I get to like create this experience for them now and for myself. And I love these conversations. They just spark so much other possibility of what can be done. And there's so many healthy ways to parent. There's so many. There's endless healthy ways to parent.
Absolutely. Look at the divorce system. You're basically, your divorce attorney sit with you and go, well, what do you want the kid's schedule to be? And I'm like, why isn't there a child psychologist as part of this conversation. You're asking me, I want them 100%. That's why I had kids. And then there's this formula on paper for like what the financials look like. You end up going through this process feeling like your kids are a formula. And I'm like, no, they're these two ages. So why aren't we talking to a specialist who understands what these two ages are going through attachment wise? And like, it's just, it's, there's still so much we need to figure out as far as like raising kids in the environment today. It's just different. Everything's different today. We were meant to be.